Hi all, welcome to our YouTube channel, and we are back again with the most important questions for Prelim 2020. Let's begin with the first question for the day. Consider the following statement. First statement, a cess is levied for a specific purpose and the proceed of cess cannot be spent on any kind of government expenditure. Second, tax proceeds are shared with state and union territories according to the guidelines by the Finance Commission. Third, the proceeds of all taxes and cesses are credited in the Consolidated Fund of India. Which of the following statements is or are correct? A. 2 only, B. 1 only, C. 1 and 3 only, D. All of the above. So guys, you can pause the video and mention your answers in the comment section below. So here, the correct answer is D. All of the above. Alright. Now, example of your cess can actually be the infrastructure cess on motor vehicles, the clean environment cess, or you could say the Krishi Kalyan cess, or the education cess, alright? So these are some of the examples. And now recently this was in news because the union government has asked all the states to take fund from the construction cess fund to give financial and other benefits to the construction workers, alright, through the direct benefit transfer, alright? So moving on to the next question. Recently seen in news, Kurza Beth Geld is a policy which partially compensates for lost earnings during uncertain economic situation. It is rolled out by which of the following country? A. Germany, 2. Norway, 3. Sweden, 4. Australia. So the correct answer here is A. Germany. Alright. So basically, due to the disruption which has been caused in the economy by the COVID-19 pandemic, there's a concern among people across the globe about the possibility of loss of job. So now, therefore, the German cabinet is planning to extend the benefit of short-time work allowance by the half of the 1st April, all right, through a legislation. So therefore, this piece of information was in news. Now, also one thing, this particular policy has been there since the World War One time, all right, and it was also used during the 2008 economic crisis which had taken place, all right. So yeah, moving on to the next question. Now, which of the following statements are correct? First, Hanta virus is named after the Hantan River in China, wherein an early outbreak was observed. Second, in Hanta virus induced hemorrhagic fever, the incubation time is 3 to 4 weeks in human. Third, Hanta virus is a double strand RNA virus. Choose the correct code. A. 1 and 2 only, B. 2 and 3 only, C. 2 only, D. 1 only. So the correct answer here is C. 2 only. Alright. Now the reason being, first of all, Hanta virus is named after the Hantan River, which is found in South Korea. So please note that this is important. It was the first outbreak was in South Korea. Alright. And the third statement is incorrect because it is a single-stranded RNA virus. Alright. So moving on to the next question. Consider the following. First, India is part of the Refugee Convention, which gives refugee legal right to education, work and property. Second, India has signed and ratified the UN Anti-Torture Convention, having non-refoulement policy. Third, India is a signatory to the New York Declaration for Refugee and Migrant. Select the correct code. A. 1 only, B. 2 only, C. 3 only, D. None. So, the correct answer here is C. 3 only. Alright. Now the reason being, first of all, India is not part of this refugee convention. Therefore, your statement 1 becomes incorrect. And second, India has only signed this particular UN anti-torture convention but has not ratified it. Therefore, your statement 2 becomes incorrect. Alright. So moving on to the next question. Consider the following statement. First, Yakshagana is a traditional theatre form of Karnataka which depicts Puranas. Second, Yakshagana is performed in Kannada only with massive headgears, elaborate costumes and facial makeup. Select the correct answer using the codes given below. A. Both, B. 1 only, C. 2 only, D. None. So guys, the correct answer here is B, one only. Alright. Now, the reason being your second statement is incorrect because this particular theatre art form or temple art form is performed in Malayalam as well as Tulu and Karnataka. Alright. Therefore, your statement 2 becomes incorrect. Now, why this was in news is because recently the Yakshagana scripts, which has been digitized and made available online by this particular registered trust called Yakshavani. Alright. So, they are basically the lovers of the Yakshagana scripts. So, therefore, this was made digitized. So, moving on to the next question. Select the correct answer using quotes given below. First, parole is a system of releasing a prisoner with suspension of his sentence. Second, furlough is granted periodically, irrespective of any reason, and merely to enable the prisoner to retain family and social ties. Third, parole is not a matter of right and may be denied to the prisoner, whereas furlough is a matter of right. Quotes A, 1 and 2 only, B, 2 and 3 only, C, none, D, all of the above. So guys, the correct answer here is D, all of the above. Alright. Now, a little piece of information is that both of this parole and furlough are covered under the Prison Act, alright? And one more important thing is that if parole is rejected to a convict, then the person can move to the High Court challenging the order of the competent authority, alright? Now, recently this was in news because Supreme Court has asked the state governments to consider giving parole to those who are facing up to 7-year jail term, alright? So that in order to decongest the prison in the midst of the recent COVID pandemic. Alright. So moving on to the next question. Which of the following statement with reference to Colombo Declaration are correct? First, the main aim of the declaration is to halve the nitrogen waste by the year 2030. Second, the Colombo Declaration was developed with technical support from the International Nitrogen Management System. Select the correct answer using the quote given below. A, one only. B, both. C, none. D, two only. So the correct answer here is B, both. All right. Now this particular concept was initiated by Sri Lanka. So please note that. All right. Moving on to the next question. Given the statements regarding tax information exchange agreement, select the correct answer using the quotes given below. First, India has notified a tax information exchange agreement with Marshall Islands. Second, the agreement enables exchange of information regarding banking and ownership. Third, the tax information exchange agreement is based on international standards of tax transparency and exchange information. Select the correct answer A, 2 and 3 only, B, 1 and 3 only, C, all, D, 1 and 2 only. So guys, the correct answer here is C, all of the above. Alright. So moving on to the next question. Marshall Island is a chain of volcanic island and coral atolls are located in which of the following oceans of the world? 1. Pacific Ocean. 2. Atlantic Ocean. 3. Indian Ocean. 4. Arctic Ocean. So, the correct answer here is 1. Pacific Ocean. Also, I asked you in the previous video which particular strait connects Red Sea to the Gulf of Ocean. So, the correct answer is Bab el Mandab. Alright. So, please note that. Moving on to the next question. Project Shaw is related to which of the following? First, a commitment by India's apparel industry to establish a sustainable pathway for the Indian fashion industry. Second, a strategy for improving coordination between power, coal and railways ministry to ensure coal supplies to power plants. Third, a strategy to provide a comprehensive overview of state level measures adopted to facilitate rooftop solar deployment. Fourth, an initiative which enable an easy and secure access of the Ministry of Corporate Affairs to the corporate entities, professional and the citizens of India. So the correct answer here is the first one, which means Project Shore is related to India's apparel industry, which will help them a sustainable pathway. All right. And also now the second one here, this particular one, A strategy for improving coordination between power, coal and railway ministry to ensure coal supplies to power plant comes under Prakash scheme, alright? That is power, rail, koila availability through supply harmony, alright? And the third one here, this particular a strategy to adopt, provide a comprehensive overview of state level measures for rooftop solar deployment comes under the Index Saral scheme, alright? State Rooftop Solar Attractiveness Index Saral scheme, alright? And the last one comes under the e-governance initiative, that is Ministry of Corporate Affairs 21 initiative, alright? So that's it for the day. For more information on our various courses, please visit our website www.aias.com. And for more such videos, like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.